हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ भवानी पिंटेला, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन नोएडा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर्म्स इंस्टीट्यूट ग्रेटर नोएडा। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू कवर एमिटिक्स एंड एंटी एमिटिक्स। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैड कवर्ड अबाउट द एंटी अल्सर ड्रग्स पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू, एंड आफ्टर ऑफ दैट आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एंटी स्टिमुलेंट्स, अपेटाइट स्टिमुलेंट ड्रग्स, कॉन्स्टिपेशन, द ड्रग्स यूज्ड इन कॉन्स्टिपेशन, ड्रग्स यूज्ड इन डायरिया। इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द अपेटाइट सप्रेसेंट ड्रग्स एंड डाइजेस्टेंट्स एंड कार्बोनेट्स। दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट इन योर फर्स्ट यूनिट विच आर एमिटिक्स एंड एंटी एमिटिक्स। विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले वी विल लेट्स ड्राइव इन टू द session. So what are any emetics? Emetics are a substances which are used, which will induces the emesis. Emesis are the substances which will induces the emesis. So which conditions are normally the emesis are the substances which not commonly used. This is a condition, this is a condition which emergency condition. So if a particular person who needs emesis in such condition, so if a particular person who having the toxicity, drug toxicity in such a condition, to emit the drug, to reduces the toxicity of a particular drug, you can give the emetics. So these are the drugs which will promote the emesis. How it will promote the emesis? It will promote the emesis by the complex series of movements which will be controlled in the vomiting centers. So if you are talking about this vomiting, it receives afferent impulse from. So the how the emesis drugs will emit the vomiting, how these drugs will induces the vomiting, these drugs will receive the afferent impulse this is a physiology of vomiting by where you can understand how the vomiting will be happened. Okay, so there are some impulses received. So from where the impulses will be released? From first one is higher centers in the brain. Higher centers in the brain is the first one. This is the first type of impulses which receives. And second one is chemoreceptor trigger zone, in shortly which you can call as an CTZ. And third one you can call as an vestibular apparatus. And fourth one you can call as an peripheral structure including ZIT. Okay, these are the four afferent impulses that can promote the emesis. What are the four? It receives as afferent impulses from which receives the vomiting center. How you can feel the vomiting? It will receive the afferent impulse from higher centers of any brain, chemoreceptor trigger zone, vestibular apparatus, and last one is peripheral structure including GI. Now we will see about the emetics. Emetics are the drugs. So when you can call the particular drug having emetic in action, if any drug induce the vomiting, such a drug you can call as an emetic drug. So these are the drugs of classification for emetics. Emetics has been classified into three types: drugs acting centrally, drugs acting peripherally, and drugs acting both centrally and peripherally. So if I am talking about the first part, centrally acting emetics. So central acting emetics are the drugs which acts on CTZ. What is in a CTZ? Chemoreceptor trigger zone. These are the drugs which act centrally on CTZ to induce the vomiting, to induce the emetic. So what are the drug comes under central acting? Apomorphine. It is any synthetic derivative. It is an a semi synthetic form of an a morphine. Okay, so apomorphine is an centrally acting emetic drug which will induces the vomiting, which acts on CTZ. By acts on CTZ, it shows emetic action. Okay, and second one is peripheral acting. In peripheral acting, you can see the mustard and hypertonic sodium chloride solution. Hypertonic sodium chloride, these are the drugs which can induces the vomiting. Next one, both central and peripheral acting drugs. What are the both central and peripheral acting drugs? Ipecacuanha. Okay, ipecacuanha is the drug which falls under both central and peripheral acting drugs. So if I am discussing about these emetic drugs, emetics are the drugs which will induces the vomiting. These emetic drugs has been categorized into three types mainly. The drugs acts on the central nervous system, the drugs acts on centrally, and the drugs acts peripherally, and the drugs, there are some drugs which acts both central centrally and peripherally. The drugs which acts on centrally, example was apomorphine. And what is the example for drugs acts on peripherally? The drugs acts on peripherally was mustard and hypotonic sodium chloride solution. And which are the drugs will falls under both central and peripheral? IP cacuana. Okay, IP cacuana is a drug which can act both centrally and peripherally to induce the vomiting. Okay, we will see one by one drug here. First one is an apomorphine. Apomorphine, what type of a drug it is? Apomorphine is such a drug which will induce the vomiting or which acts on CTZ. When it acts on CTZ, the apomorphine is such a drug which will induces the emesis, which will induces the vomiting. It is a semi-synthetic derivative of morphine. So, morphine is a natural substances, natural opioid. Right, morphine is a natural opioid. It is a narcotic drug. Thus, apomorphine is a semi-synthetic derivative of any morphine. When you had administered the apomorphine to induce the vomiting by subcutaneous route, okay, when you had given apomorphine by subcutaneous route within 15 minutes, in which route? Subcutaneous route. Okay, when you had administered apomorphine on subcutaneous route, within 15 minutes it can induces the vomiting. Okay, so this is the dopaminergic agonist in CTZ. When you had given in a little bit more dose, what drug it is? Apomorphine. If you had given apomorphine in a high dose, which can causes the respiratory depression. But this respiratory depression can be treated by giving the antidote, which are the opioid antagonist drug. Which opioid antagonist drug you are giving here? Nalorphine. Nalorphine is an opioid antagonist which acts as an antidote to treat the respiratory depression. Because apomorphine is such a drug, when you had given in a high dose, which having capability to induce or which having capability to produce the respiratory depression, and it sometimes it can causes a decrease in blood pressure also. This decrease in blood pressure or decrease in respiratory system. So, if the major toxicity of this drug was respiratory depression, this respiratory depression will be treated by giving of antidote. Which type of antidote you can give here? Opioid antagonist drug. Which type of opioid antagonist drug? Nalorphine. Nalorphine, it means in which dose you can give in to treat the respiratory depression? With the 5 to 10 mg. At the 5 to 10 mg dose, you can give the nalorphine drug to treat the respiratory depression. Apomorphine is a semi-synthetic drug which is used to induce the vomiting. It can given by the subcutaneous route, it can given by the intramuscular or intravenous route. When you had given by the subcutaneous route within 15 minutes, it can shown emetic action, it can induces the vomiting, right? The apomorphine is a strong emetic drug. It is a very strong emetic drug. Right, and this is not recommended. Okay, this apomorphine is a drug orally it is not recommended. If you had increased its dose in a little bit manner, it can causes the respiratory depression. The respiratory depression can be treated by giving the nalorphine drug with 5 to 10 mg. And next one, there are some drugs which can produces the vomiting. These are some drugs which can cause the vomiting. So these are all the emetic drugs. These are all the emetic drugs which can induce the vomiting. So these are the lot of the drugs which are used for the particular treatment. So particular disease or particular disorder, if you are to treat the particular disorder, we are taking the lot of drugs. So to treat the particular disorder, for example, erythromycin is an antibiotic. This is an antibiotic which are used to treat the microorganisms. If these are used to treat the microorganisms, at this condition, this is the drug which can induces the vomiting. So to treat the particular disorder, we will take the particular drug. This particular drug, there are some few drugs which can induces the vomiting. If you see here, there are lot of drugs which can induces the vomiting. So what are the drugs which can induces the vomiting? Erythromycin, which type of drug it is? Just now I had said you, it is an antibiotic. So it is an antibiotic which are used to kill the microorganism. And next one, tetracycline. It is also an antibiotic which are used to treat the microorganisms, which are used to kill the microorganisms. Okay. Anti-cancer drugs. Anti-cancer drugs are also induce the vomiting. Anti-cancer drugs, if particular person who are taking the chemotherapy, if a particular person who are taking the anti-cancer drugs, these are the drugs which having capacity to increase the vomiting. So, anti-cancer drugs are also promote the vomiting. Next one, morphine. Which type of drug it is? Morphine is an opioid drug. It is an narcotic drug. When you have taken the opioid or the narcotic drug like morphine, it can having capacity to induce the vomiting. Next, quinine. Quinine, which type of drug it is? Quinine is an anti-malarial drug which is used to treat the malaria. If you are taking the quinine to treat the malaria, this drug having capacity to induce the vomiting in a particular patient. Okay, next one, diltiazem. So, which type of drug it is? Diltiazem is an a calcium channel blocker. This is an a calcium channel blocker which is used to treat the hypertension. So, when you had given this diltiazem to treat the hypertension in a particular person or particular patient, then this drug will induces the, it will increases the vomiting sensation. Okay, what category it is? It is an a calcium channel blocker. Okay, the name itself having emetine. Emetine, it is an a drug which can induces the vomiting, which can induces the emesis. Okay, ergot alkaloids or ergot derivatives. Ergot derivatives are also a drugs which can induces the vomiting. Okay, so these are all the drugs which having capacity to induce the vomiting. Let me see what are the drugs they are. Anti microbial drugs like erythromycin, tetracycline. If you are taking the anti-cancer drugs, these are also drugs having capability to increase the vomiting. Okay, it will act on CTG and it will induces the vomiting. If I am talking about the morphine, quinine, diltiazem, emetine drug, ergot alkaloids or ergot derivatives, all these drugs having capacity to increase the vomiting. It will induces the vomiting. Okay, and one more thing you have to remember here, the apomorphine. If I am talking about here apomorphine, which I had explained about here apomorphine. So, if I am talking about the peripheral acting drugs like the mustard, this is the mustard which is available very easily. This is an home which is available at the home, which is available easily, and this mustard can also induces the emesis. It can induces the vomiting. By mixing of 1 teaspoon of mustard in the 1 glass of water, it can induces the vomiting. It acts by peripherally and it will shows the emetic in action. Next one, ipecacuanha. Ipecacuanha is an a drug which is an a, it consists, ipecacuanha is an a drug, it consists of an alkaloid emetine. Okay, if you are talking about this drug, it consists of an alkaloid which is named as emetine. This emetine which can induces the vomiting. Relatively, it is safe to give for the infants, but if any condition has been obtained to give the emetic drug, so ipecacuanha is an a preferred drug. Relatively it is preferred to produce the vomiting. Okay, so this is about the apomorphine, mustards and ipecacuanha. So among that, ipecacuanha is a relatively safe drug which you can given or which can produces the vomiting. And if I am talking about emesis, the emetic drugs should not given in a such a condition. In which condition you should not give the emetics? Emetics are the drugs you should not given in a such a condition, like those who having renal problems, the particular person who having renal problems, or particular person who is suffering from the hypertension, or the particular person who is suffering from the pulmonary tuberculosis. In a such a condition, you should not give the emetic drugs, and it should be avoided in the children's, especially in infants, neonates. And these are the drugs should not be given to the pregnancy women and elderly persons. Okay, so the emetins are the drugs you should not prefer to give to the infants, neonates, pregnant women and elder people, and those conditions, those particular person having disorders like hypertension, congestive heart failure, pulmonary, if I am talking about the pulmonary tuberculosis, in such a condition you should not advise to give the emetic drugs. Next, we will discuss about the anti-emetics. So, it is an opposite to the emesis. So, if any particular person having emesis or particular person having vomiting sensation, to decrease this vomiting sensation, you can give the anti-emetic drugs. So, what are the anti-emetic drugs? Anti-emetics are the drugs which will decreases the vomiting sensation. Let me move to the classification. So, what are the drugs comes under anti-emetics? Anticholinergics. So, anticholinergics are the drugs which falls under antiemetics. Next one, H1 antihistamines. H1 antihistamines are also drugs falls under antiemetics. Neuroleptics, which you can call as an D2 blockers. Prokinetics, okay, and 5-HT3 antagonists and others. Okay, these are the drugs which can call which are used to treat the vomiting. So these are all the drugs which are used to treat the vomiting, which are called as an antiemetic drugs. First one is anticholinergic drugs. So cholinergics are the drugs which can induce the vomiting. So anticholinergics are the drugs which can inhibit the vomiting sensation. So hyoscine, diclomine, these are the drugs falls under anticholinergics. H1 antihistamines are the drugs which are used to treat the emesis, so particular person who having the vomiting, so you can give the H1 antihistamine drugs. What are the H1 antihistamine drugs? Promethazine, diphenhydramine, dimethyldramine, cyclizine, meclizine. So there are a lot of drugs, H1 antagonist drugs, to treat the vomiting. And third one is neuroleptics. So neuroleptics are also called as dopamine blockers. So neuroleptics, what is the next name for the neuroleptics? What is the other name for the neuroleptics? Neuroleptics, which you can call as any dopamine blockers. So, chlorpromazine. Okay, chlorpromazine is a dopamine blocker which can use to treat the vomiting. It is used as an anti-emetic drug. Next one, 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist. Because 5-hydroxytryptamine is a serotonin which can induce the emesis. But these antagonist drugs which will inhibit the emesis, which will inhibit the vomiting sensation. So we will give the 5-HT3, especially 5-HT3 antagonist. 5-HT3 antagonist is used as an anti-emetic drug, especially it is used in the which is given in the anesthesia. When the particular person is prescribing the anesthesia, who having the vomiting sensation, in a pre-anesthetic drug, you can give it as a pre-anesthetic drug. Okay, and other drugs like dexamethasone, benzodiazepines. What the type of drug it is? Benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines are the diazepines drugs. These are the drugs are also used to treat the emesis. So what are the classification of an emesis? So what the drugs fall under emesis? Anticholinergic drugs, histamine antagonist drugs, D2 blockers, which you can call as any neuroleptics, prokinetics. Prokinetics are also drugs you can use it here. Prokinetics are also drugs which are used to treat the vomiting sensation, and 5-hydroxytryptamine antagonist. These are the drugs which can inhibit the vomiting sensation. There are other drugs like dexamethasone, right? And benzodiazepines, these are also drugs which are used to treat the vomiting sensation and which are acts as an anti-emetic drugs. So these are all the classification which falls under anti-emetics, right? And now we will move to the next one, anti-emetics. First we will discuss about the anticholinergics. In cholinergics, first one is hyoscine. Hyoscine is used as an motion sickness. So where you can use the hyoscine drug? The hyoscine is a drug which used in the motion sickness. In which dose you have given here? 0.2 to 0.4 mg in intramuscular route. By intramuscular route, 0.2 to 0.4 mg, you can treat the motion sickness. Which type of drug it is? Hyoscine is an anticholinergic drug used to treat the vomiting sensation. So which type of vomiting sensation it can create the motion sickness? At which dose you can give this drug? 0.2 to 0.4 mg. At which route? Intramuscular route. By giving it in intramuscular route, at a particular dose you can treat the motion sickness. Okay. And it can be used in intramuscular route, it can used as an intra IV subcutaneous route, but short acting action. These are the drugs having short action. What is the mechanism of action? The mechanism of action of anticholinergic was it will block the cholinergic link of vestibular apparatus. When I had discussed the physiology of emetics, I had explained the impulses has been for higher centers, from where you can induce the vomiting, from the higher centers, CTJ, vestibular apparatus. Okay, this is also one of the reason by where you can see the inducing of vomiting. So the anticholinergics are the drugs which will block the cholinergic system, especially the link of vestibular apparatus of a vomiting center. By blocking of this center, what is going to happen? The emesis which will be induced will be get suppressed, will be get blocked. and what are the adverse drug reaction of this thiazide? Adverse drug reactions like you can see sedation, dry mouth, anticholinergic effects. So these are all the adverse effects. Next we'll move to the H1 antihistamines. H1 antihistamines are the drugs which acts on vomiting centers and having the mild sedative in action. So these are the drugs which are used in the motion sickness and especially in the pregnancy women. So pregnancy, most of the pregnancy women at the first trimester condition, the particular woman will face the emesis problem. In a such a condition, you can administer or you can give the histamine antagonist drugs. And next one, neuroleptics. Neuroleptics are also called as any dopamine blockers. Okay, these are also called as any dopamine blockers. So these are the useful in inducing the post anesthesia. So in which condition the neuroleptics drugs are used, in which condition the neuroleptic drugs has been prescribed, the neuroleptic drugs has been prescribed in the post anesthetic nausea and vomiting condition. So who having the post anesthesia, after its anesthetic, after a post anesthesia, after of anesthesia, the particular person will have the nausea and vomiting sensation. Nausea, what is mean by nausea? Nausea is in a condition where you can see, where you can feel vomiting like sensation, but you not get the vomiting. Okay, nausea is in a condition where you can feel the vomiting sensation, but it not produces the vomiting. You cannot get the vomiting, it just a feel of any vomiting sensation. In a post operative nausea and vomiting condition, you can give the dopamine blockers, neuroleptics. Okay, in cancer chemotherapy, in a cancer, those who are taking the anti-cancer drugs, it can induces the emesis. In such a conditions also you can give the neuroleptics. Radiation sickness, in radiation sickness also you can give the neuroleptics. Motion sickness, in the motion sickness also you can give the neuroleptics. But what is the major adverse drug reaction of this neuroleptics? It causes the sedation, acute muscle dystonia, and diagnosis of the cause first should be administered. So first you have to know what is the cause of the particular thing, and then you have to administer the drug. These are the major side effects with the drug. So this is about the neuroleptics. Neuroleptics are also called as a dopamine blockers, and in which condition you are using these drugs, these are the conditions which in a conditions like a chemotherapy, those who are taking the cancer chemotherapy, those who are taking the radiant sickness, in radiant sickness condition also you can give the anti-emetic drugs. You can, the particular person who having the motion sickness, if the particular person who having the motion sickness, in such a condition also you can give the dopamine blockers. And what is the major adverse drug reaction? Sedation, acute muscle dystonia. And next one is prokinetics, metoclopramide. Prokinetics, what is the example of prokinetics? Metoclopramide. These are the drugs which acts on GIT, especially on upper GIT tract. Metoclopramide, it is an prokinetic drug which is used to suppress the vomiting. These are the drugs which acts as an anti-emetic drug. The metoclopramide, the prokinetic drugs which has an anti-emetic drugs which will inhibit the vomiting. How it will inhibit the vomiting? By acting on a GIT, on especially on the upper GIT tract. It will increases the gastric peristalsis and relax the pylorus and first part of any duodenum. Okay, how it will, how I just now had said you that the on acting on upper respiratory tract, it will shows the anti-emetic action. It will increases the gastric peristalsis. By increasing gastric peristalsis, and it relax the pylorus and first part of duodenum, and better gastric empty. Okay, and what is mean by LES? Lower esophageal sphincter. Lower esophageal sphincter tone also get increased by taking of these prokinetic drugs, especially metoclopramide. By giving of this metoclopramide anti-emetic drug, you can decreases or you can increases the tone of lower esophageal sphincter. Okay, and also increases the intestinal peristalsis. So this metoclopramide drug also increases the intestinal peristalsis. It not only increases the lower, lower esophageal sphincter, it also increases the peristalsis movement in the intestine. Right, actions on CNS, if you see it, action on CNS, you know that the apomorphine is in a drug which can induces the vomiting by acting on centrally. So with the drug which induces the vomiting, it can block the apomorphine induced vomiting can be blocked by these prokinetic drugs. I am repeating one more time, prokinetics are the drugs which can use it to treat the emesis. So the particular person who having vomiting sensation, in such a conditions you can give the anti-emetic drugs like prokinetics. kinetics. Prokinetics are the drugs which are example. What are the example falls under this category? Metoclopramide. These are the drugs which acts on GIT, especially on upper part of an GIT. It will increases the tone of LGS, and it also will increases the tone. It also increases the intestinal peristalsis. And the next one is 5-HT3 antagonist. 5-HT3 antagonist was an ondansetron. This is in a drug which is used as an anti-anitic drug. Well known drug ondansetron is an 5-HT3 antagonist drug. You can use it in the chemotherapy in a particular person who are taking the chemotherapy. In a chemotherapy medication, the particular person can induce the vomiting. The particular drugs can induce the vomiting. In such a condition, you can give the 5-HT3 antagonist drugs. And in PONV, what is mean by PONV? Post-operative nausea and vomiting. Post-operative nausea and vomiting condition also we can give the 5-hydroxytryptamine. So this 5-hydroxytryptamine will act peripherally and centrally, and it will block the 5-hydroxytryptamine action. The 5-hydroxytryptamine, this is a serotonin. 5-hydroxytryptamine is also called as a serotonin. When it bind to its receptor, it will induce the vomiting. So these serotonin antagonists are the drugs which will bind to the serotonergic receptor, and it will block the action of a serotonin. How it will block the action of serotonin? By acting centrally and peripherally, both, okay, and by acting on this action, it will inhibit the centrally, and it will blocks the depolarization action of 5-HT receptor in the vagus of GIT and CTJ. So the receptors which are present on GIT and CTJ, these receptors will be get inhibited by the 5-HT3 antagonist drugs. So by this, you can treat the emesis problem. And this is the drug which you can use it if you had given any drug like apomorphine in a such a condition. Also, apomorphine is a drug which can induces the vomiting. If you are given the any opioid drug, apomorphine is an a derivative. It is an a semi-synthetic derivative of an a morphine derivative, a morphine drug. If any person have to take the apomorphine, the apomorphine is a drug which can induces the emesis. In a such a condition also, you can give this a drug like 5-HT antagonist. Ondansetron adverse drug reactions, we well known adverse drug reaction like headache, dizziness, constipation, abdominal discomfort, hypertension, all these are the side effects with the ondansetron. Next one, NK1 receptor antagonist. NK1 stands for neurokinin 1 receptor antagonist. Neurokinin is a receptor which is responsible for vomiting. So by blocking of this NK receptor, we can inhibit the vomiting. So these are the drugs by which it can show its mechanism of action. Thank you.